Mahaban, everybody.
Mahaban. Mahaban.
Oh my God, that is such a mess.
But wallahi, I can't believe it. After 2 years, I never thought this day would come. But ladies and gentlemen, the Newcastle United takeover has finally been completed. And as you can very clearly tell, I'm doing my best not to get too carried away. Mike Ashley is gone. Oh my God, he's leaving with about 300 million in his pocket. That's his reward, apparently. His reward for completely... I think I'm going to take this off now, in all honesty. Like I said, it's hard not to get carried away at the moment. But yeah, Mike Ashley is walking away with about 300 million in his pocket, and that is his reward for basically killing the club in his time in charge. Oh my God, my hair is going to be all over the place now. Great. God, I don't know. Can I like swing it that way? Maybe, No, probably not. I don't think, you know, I just can't win. All right, I guess we're rocking a cap for this episode today. But yes, Mike Ashley is only going to go and walk away with 300 million after selling finally the Newcastle United Football Club. After 14 years and about 2 relegations and 1 actually decent season in that entire time, he has been loaded into the catapult and flung the hell out of here. In comes now Amanda Staveley and the public investment firm of Saudi Arabia, which means that Newcastle United are currently now the richest club in football, or at the least, we have the richest backers in football. Today, I'm going to break down the entire takeover, my thoughts as a Newcastle United fan, and of course, we have to start off by talking about the new owners, PIF, who are backed by the Saudi royal family. These guys have about 10 times more wealth at their disposal than the owners of Manchester City, okay? Do you know how wild that is? Can you actually believe that is true? Sheikh Mansour and his backing with Man City is 23 billion. And then you've got Bin Salman, who's over 300 billion. That game in a couple of years, not straight away, obviously, will become one of the bigger derbies in the Premier League. We're gonna have a real life El Clasico in the Premier League. Now, as a Newcastle United fan, let me talk about expectations. Starting off with what my expectations were before this transfer even happened.
Reckon I can probably put that back up now too, by the way.
All I think any Newcastle fan wanted, including myself, was to fight before the takeover for top 10. That was really about it. Newcastle United is by far one of the top 10 biggest teams in England, without question. But Newcastle United in the last 15 years have only finished inside of the top 10 once in 15 years. That is how bad things have been under Mike Ashley. And then you add 2 relegations on top of that. We have only ever wanted a team that showed a little bit of ambition and just put in a shift every single game day and got a position at the end of the season that we deemed worthy of a club this size, which we believe would be even just a mid-table finish, not a relegation battle, or actually, God forbid, a genuine relegation almost every couple of seasons. Just a team that was capable of getting top 10 reasonably consistently, okay? Not fighting or actually competing for European competitions like a couple of deluded pundits would have you believe. But what are my expectations now after the staggering amount of money, the numbers that are being floated around right now? It is honestly impossible not to get a little carried away, as you could probably tell from the intro. Well, I do not believe we are obviously going to turn into Manchester City or PSG overnight. I think any football fan, surely, using logic, will come to that conclusion. We still have a team that currently right now is underperforming drastically in the Premier League, okay? We're like 19th, I think, without a win. I think Bruce needs to go. And of course, the sooner the better. We have to get a gaffer in for the long haul. I think that is the number one thing that this football club needs to be focusing on when the transfer is all said and done. We got to get Bruce out and we have to get in a man that can get the job done and take us forward for a couple of good few seasons, I would say. Right now, obviously, there are a few names being floated. I personally quite like Antonio Conte. I think that's probably one of the more realistic shouts, I think, at the moment, which is mad to think. But hey, it was mad that we even got Rafa Benitez. I think he would be a good fit. He's a proven gaffer. He has won the Serie A multiple times. He won the Premier League, of course, with Chelsea. If we don't end up with him, another name that's being floated is Eddie Howe. And I actually really would have liked to have had Eddie Howe as our manager, but maybe before the takeover. I would have loved for him to have been the gaffer over Steve Bruce, that's for sure. So I'm not sure if we go with Eddie Howe, and obviously Zidane's there, but I don't even think that's worth talking about. I don't think that's going to happen. One name and one manager that I really haven't had I haven't seen linked with Newcastle at all since all this news has broken, but someone I personally would love to see Newcastle United go for would actually be Erik ten Hag, the manager of Ajax. Not even remotely linked with a move to Newcastle, and it probably won't happen, but he's just a personal pick for me. He did some very, very special teams with Ajax. He does very, very well in that sort of a team, where it's usually young players who are developing, still getting better, and typically in that Ajax team, the best players, they end up just moving on to bigger clubs. Well, if we are a club now, that is one of the bigger clubs. If we turn into a team that people don't end up leaving, like Ajax, to go to bigger and better places, maybe we could give Erik ten Hag a team and a core group of good quality youngsters that he can continue to develop, build an identity in a team. I'm just getting wet thinking of it. He can just keep making one team stronger and stronger. Imagine if that side that made the Champions League semi-final with Ajax, if he had kept that all together, what do you think that team could have accomplished? I also really, by the way, hope we keep a hold of Graham Jones. I know he's just the coach. He's not actually a manager. He's like assistant manager or whatever his role is within the Newcastle United coaching staff. But I don't think it's his time yet to be manager, but I think he's going to be a quality coach, and I really hope he sticks around. Maybe later down the track, he could potentially be a possible manager. But I think it's too early to give him the keys. But I mean, again, I really do hope we keep hold of him. Hell, I would have loved to have had Rafa. Imagine what Rafa could have done with this team, with this sort of backing. Hell, imagine what he could have done if Mike Ashley had actually backed him. He'd probably be doing what we're seeing with Everton, but instead at Newcastle. Too late to make that happen though, of course, after he just joined Everton. So yeah, I know, it's just another failing of Mike Ashley. Of course, I want us to actually go for some quality in January. We don't even have to start looking at, you know, really starting the rebuild or completely bringing in those young players to maybe take us forward. I honestly just want to stay up this season. That is pure and simple all I want us to do this season. We need to bring in the quality in January that will ensure survival in the Premier League. I don't care if we finish 16th or 17th, just don't finish in the bottom three. Just because we now have more money than God, apparently, does not make the squad of players that we have now any better. I am honest to God serious. I don't care where we finish this season. I have no immediate expectations aside from just stay up. And then, hopefully, in the second season, in that offseason, that's when finally we begin the rebuild. We need then to go out and to find those good core quality players that are going to stick with this club for the long haul and take this club forward. We need to start, if we're going to look at Manchester City, finding our Vincent Kompany, our Sergio Aguero, our David Silva, and then over time add the quality players around them. That's what we've got to look to do. Which players specifically we should be going for, I actually really don't know. In my opinion, it really starts with the manager, because you shouldn't be thinking about players first. You've got to get a manager in, figure out what your system is, how you're going to play, and then go for players. And with just apparently the world at our oyster with the ridiculous amount of cash that's being floated around or possibly being invested into this football club, literally, people saying we're going for Mbappe and being unsarcastic. I'm not saying that's going to happen, but people genuinely thinking with the stupid backing that this football club is now going to get, that it could actually maybe somehow be or in the realm of possibility. I don't think we need to go that big. Not that crazy hard straight away. On top of the team as well, we desperately need to invest in the club facilities that need a mega upgrade. Mike Ashley was so tight with cash when he was at the helm of Newcastle United that he let St. James's Park borderline fall apart. And for Christ's sakes, our players are taking ice baths in bins. That's how bad things were. Don't say that this football club has not deserved this moment. Have a look at Leicester City's new training facilities. They are absolutely immaculate. They are fantastic. State of the art, something like that, yes please, would be incredible for our players for a start. And I know that that too is going to take a good couple of years. That's not something that just gets built overnight. I'm fully prepared for this to become a process, and I hope every Newcastle fan is the same. The city, I am sure as well, of Newcastle is going to get a mega amount of investment in it too, which it's just, it warms my heart. The possibility of that city getting hundreds of millions of pounds being driven into it, from my time there, makes me so happy. I mean, it was an amazing experience to be over there for my first game a long, good couple of years ago. And I just can't wait to go back again after this. No, seriously. Eventually, when Australia finally lets me leave in the middle of this damn pandemic. I want to see my football team, ScoMo. Let me fly. But I'm hoping after about 2-3 seasons, maybe around 2024, that's hopefully the time where Newcastle finally get firing after hopefully getting set up a little bit. That's the time I think maybe we then start contending for some kind of European football, whether it be just Europa League or Champions League. I don't know. I really don't know. This takeover still has, of course, so many question marks over it now that it's borderline done or possibly done by the time this video is, you know, out and about. It could be a dream ride all the way to Premier League, Champions League glory, or we might not get anywhere near the amount of backing that we thought we were going to get compared to Manchester City or PSG. Who knows what the new owners exactly have in mind, but of course, talking about the new owners, we do have to touch on this. I really don't feel like it is my place, or to be completely honest, any other person's place to criticize Newcastle fans for being incredibly excited about this takeover. However you feel about sports washing, and yes, as a Newcastle fan, even I have to own up and admit that this is pretty well sports washing. Saudi Arabia has already invested in several sporting teams like Manchester United, Sheffield United, as well as the McLaren F1 team. Aramco is a partner of the EFL Championship. You've got even boxing and WWE backed by Saudi Arabia. They've invested into it as well. You can feel how you want to feel about this takeover, but however you feel about the takeover, I feel like it's only fair that you should carry that same feeling for everything else. Because what it feels like to me is that everyone is so fixated on this takeover, but they do turn a blind eye to everything else. And when people do that, it's hard for those people's opinions not to be tarnished in my own eyes. If you can acknowledge both, I will completely and utterly respect whatever view, stance, or opinion that you may hold. At the end of the day, though, and this isn't even really me talking, this is just the reality of the situation, pure and simple, this is a business and cash is king. Big businesses have never exactly been known for being the greatest pillars of our society, have they? Facebook literally just got exposed for trying to incite as much hatred as possible to drive engagement. Tobacco companies are making a living out of killing their customers. Nike and other apparel brands, maybe even possibly these guys, use sweatshops to exploit some of the poorest people alive. And I'm sure some of you watching right now that maybe don't necessarily agree with this takeover on moral grounds, how much do you want to bet that some of you are wearing Nike right now? And even if you're not right now, you probably own a couple of shirts, maybe some shoes, but do you question it? No, of course you don't, because it's not what you think about when you're putting it on. Does that make you a hypocrite then for thinking that? I don't think it does, but it should give you a bit of an insight into what it's currently like to be a Newcastle United fan in this situation. If the PIF of Saudi Arabia are able to invest in things like Uber and Boeing, then there's really no reason why a football club they should not be also allowed to invest in. And there is a fact that we all need to admit, and this just goes beyond Newcastle in general. If all the money in sport only came specifically from squeaky clean sources with absolutely no questionable backgrounds whatsoever, both legally or morally, there would almost be no sport, at least not even close to the way that it's resembled today, the way that we all love it. I'm not saying that it makes it right, I'm saying it's the truth. I just ask that your opinion on PIF now owning Newcastle stays consistent with everything else that they are allowed to be a part of. And just by the way, I will never tell you your feelings of PIF owning Newcastle is in any way wrong. But as a Newcastle fan, all I see and all I feel is just the optimism of how big this is, because I know how big this is for the club, for the fans, and more importantly, for just the city as a whole. For these people, the football club is nearly everything. It's borderline religious over there. And these fans that have waited so long for this moment, I don't think that they deserve to be made a certain way for being excited about the future of their football club. And I apologize for getting a little bit deep there, but like that's how I'm feeling right now. It's a mix of emotions. I feel like I'm living in dreamland. I feel like I'm living in a literal career mode. I can't believe it. It's genuinely happening. Newcastle United on paper are now the richest football team in the world. This team that I supported in like the mid-2000s when I was a youngster first getting into football. And now I don't know what the future holds. It's going to be an amazing ride and I cannot wait to see what is going to happen. It's going to be an incredibly interesting next couple of months. But yeah, wow. They're my thoughts on the takeover, people. I'm probably going to make, I think, a lot more Newcastle United content now because I maybe was slacking a little bit in the last couple of years, but this club has now just earned the attention of every single person in the world of football. Nothing is guaranteed in life at all. Nothing is guaranteed in football, but we are on the course to become one of the powerhouses in world football. And who knows how long it's going to take, if it will even happen. I'm trying my best to remain humble, as you could very clearly tell from the intro, but I would love to have you along for the ride. So if you are indeed new and you have indeed enjoyed, then be sure to like and especially subscribe because there is plenty more coming around the corner. Oh my God, what a time to be alive. Thank you all so much for watching. My name is The Master Bucks. Do not forget to like and subscribe and I will catch you next time. See you later and bye-bye.